Is it a problem to have dual citizenship and want to serve? And for you, what are the different dynamics that come to play?
Well, it should not be a problem as far as I'm concerned. People or citizens of a country living in the diaspora and participating in the affairs of that country is as ancient as history. I mean, it goes all the way to Jesus Christ, who was a diasporan. Joseph was a diasporan when he helped his brothers. You know, when he came to Ghana, we talk famously about the case of Nkrumah and many others. And in actual fact, I am told that the founder of the Ashanti Nation, Osei-Tutu, was an Ashanti diasporan who lived in Akwamu, who returned with his experiences to found his country. On behalf of diasporans, I can tell my fellow Ghanaians that those of us who live outside are fully Ghanaians, not even because we were born in Ghana's geographical space, but because I assert fully that Ghana was born in us. I think that it is something we ought to cherish, that people who were born Ghanaian and have lived elsewhere still want to participate in our affairs. I think that we bring a lot of wealth. You know, when you look at 2021 figures, Ghanaians in the diaspora contributed 4.2 billion to our economy. That is a little over 6% of our GDP. It's not even just the contribution. We bring a lot of talent. And in actual fact, it is the same logic that makes Ghanaians want diasporans participate in the national team, the Black Stars, because they know instinctively that it makes us better when we can gather Ghanaians from all around the world. So I actually think that President John Mahama's pronouncements are very welcome. Of course, when we say that we ought to welcome or acknowledge the signal contributions of the John Adikum Kufuor government, which passed rule power in 2006, and it is a disgrace that we still have not implemented it. In actual fact, rule power might be a more signal step than even the dual citizenship we are talking about. And the dual citizenship has a bill in front of parliament which a lot of people have contributed. So President Mahama's pronouncement is right on point, and I think it should be commended. And the MPP, in this tradition of helping to advance the frontiers of our democracy, should go back and do what it needs to do and join it. And by the way, we always brag about being the torchbearers of Africans. This time, we are not even leading, apart from, of course, the examples of US and Canada doing that. Even in Africa, Nigeria, Senegal, South Africa, Cape Verde, all allow their citizenship in the diaspora to vote, and nothing untoward has happened. Indeed, Senegal has representatives to its parliament from the diaspora.